and gentlemen, I welcome you all back again here for something very, very interesting. Let us all proceed with knowing how to win consumers in the mobile first age, which truly is the need of the hour. And to do the honors for this great session, may we please put our hands together for Mr. Sandeep Ranade, Executive Director, Kantar, to share his insights on the topic. We are all very busy with our clicks in our hand. Everything is on the tip of a button, tip of a click. So let's hear it by Mr. Sandeep Ranade. Hearty welcome to you, sir.
Thank you.
And you do understand, along with coffee break comes tons of energy as well. So with a little bit more energy and lots of love, may I please humbly request you all, ladies and gentlemen, to kindly take your seats. Thank you. Over to you, Mr. Sandeep. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Okay, since morning we have been talking about technology, insights, delight, design. Yeah? So coming back to winning consumers on mobile, let's see what we are going to see here. Let me set the context. Does it work? Yeah. So we spoke since morning that our industry is evolving. I think Mr. Sachin Jain mentioned we are in the business of generations. Yeah. So the industry is evolving. We also talked about the word nowadays that is being used called phygital, which is online and offline, both being important. That will become more so in 2020. We know that. But the fact also is that all the ways we get in touch with our consumers, the touch points we use, are also evolving rapidly, right? So it's not just our industry, it's the touch points which are evolving. Consumers are seeing more and more content on more and more platforms. Yeah? So how do we win consumers in this mobile first age? Now, before I move ahead, I wanted to put one thing, which again you might know, but put data. Through the presentation, if I say digital, what I wanted to tell you is digital is equal to mobile in India. So what I'm showing here is there is a number that floats around in the industry saying there are about 500 million active internet users in India, right? But if you see, almost all of them do access internet on their mobile, right? Though these numbers are 17 to 18, the numbers are growing. And the time spent, there are numbers like consumers are spending about 6 hours on their mobile, right? If you look at 2019, we have now about 30 plus OTT. Do you know the OTT platforms, the web streaming apps, which are the Netflixes, the Hotstars? So the numbers would have increased. So through the presentation, when I say digital, I'm saying mobile. Yes, RTG does have their pads, their laptops where they access us. But yes, most consumers are accessing online through mobile. The second bit, the question every advertiser will have or every businessman will have is, I am putting money on media. Kya ho raha hai? Am I seeing my sales grow up? Is it that when I put money, the sales will always grow up? So we actually do multimedia campaign evaluation without getting into the details. And we have tested about 70 plus campaigns. And if you look at on the left, I'm showing 2012 to mid 2016, and on the right, 2016 to 18. So the campaigns that we have tested, so it may be representative of the industry, does show the spends on digital are increasing in multimedia campaigns. Why July 2016 as the cutoff? The Jio effect happened. We know after Jio, people got more and more access to internet at lower prices, right? So the spends, maybe in this category, the jewelry category, the spends on digital in a multimedia campaign are still higher. But what we have also seen when we measure those campaigns is the impact those campaigns have on brand metrics. And I'm not talking clicks here. I'm talking whether the campaign let my brand awareness go up because of the campaign with consumers, or the consumer's purchase intention went up because of the campaign. So the contribution of digital to those impacts has also gone up over the two periods, if you see, right? So that's one part. So what we are looking at now is there are consumers who are spending 4 to 6 hours on their mobile. They have their purchase journey for a jewelry, right? How do we come into that journey and use it in the best possible way to connect with them, to be meaningful, to be informative to them, and also being memorable? That's when they will lead through the journey and end up purchasing a brand, right? So to be meaningful, informative, memorable, on media, it is also one about your creative, the also about how you deploy the creatives, right? There are both these things that come up. So I'm going to talk to you about just 4 learnings that we see when you deploy creatives or make creatives, especially for digital media. Now, context matters. Simple, but let's talk about it. We do survey advertisers and agencies globally. And if you look at it, what they are saying, most of them say, we know, we understand the importance of custom content. But when we ask them, do you understand the impact of context when it comes to your creative executions, about 1/3 are not very confident, right? They say, we don't know. We are not confident as to how context impacts our creatives. So the first thing there is to understand, when we say context, what is context in a digital media? One, it is where your ad or creative is, and also what is around it in the platform or the environment, the wrap around it. But it's not just that. It is also the mood and the mindset of the consumer when he or she is in that app or is engaging with that app, right? Both become context. So let me give you an example. If you are on a social media, right? Social, say Facebook, you are in a laid back mood, you want to kill time, and your ad, if you are placing on Facebook, is actually competing with the posts of the friends and relatives or whatever of the consumer. Whereas if the consumer is looking at an online video, they are in a lean forward mode. Maybe they are looking for entertainment. They have a mission there. So these context and the mood of the consumer impacts how they consume the creative, right? So that's where context comes in. So let's look at, some data again. On the left is video, on the right is social, and there are 3 lines. When advertisers ran 6 seconders, 15 seconders, and 30 seconders. Okay, this data comes from global studies, not very different for India. What it is showing is, across all the tested creatives, actually, on an average, consumers skip a video after 7 to 8 seconds, right? But when they are consuming a video, the audio is on, the completion rate is about 40%, even if they skip. Whereas if you go to social, the skip is far faster. It's as soon as 3 seconds. Right? So if I run the same creative on a YouTube and Facebook, and my brand comes after 7 seconds or after 4th second, the impact will be very different. Most people do social without the sound being on, right? And the completion rate is lower. So now how do I make my creatives that they are customized to this context so that I make most of what I'm putting in the media, right? I'll give you an example for both. So the left-hand side is a video. Request if you can play it.
You can skip this ad, but then you'll electrocute this puppy. Good for you. You just saved the puppy. And in the process, you cost Nail Communications about 50 cents. But that's all right with us. Because when we get the bill from YouTube for this ad, we'll donate the same exact amount to the ASPCA to save some more puppies. Click here so you can do the same.
Yeah, you get a larger frame to engage. You can bring in emotional engagement, use audio, use music, right? Utilize that window, but bring in the brand early before the skip. Or you can make the video interesting that the skip is extended. Now let's look at the second video on the right, which is, I'm not putting them blowing screen because on mobile they see the video only at that level. So they are not blown whole screen. No, the second one, please.
Oh. Is anything happening?
I can't see you. You gotta tell me, man.
What's going on? This is a gift.
Did you expect it was a contact lenses ad on a Facebook context? So grab attention with unexpected situations. The caption needs to make them stay, right? Branding very fast, though in this, I don't think whether that happens so that fast. And don't rely on audio if you are on Facebook. So your video should be strong enough that without audio, it gives its message. So again, you have creatives, but how do you use the context to make them more relevant and catching that the consumer stays with them and you get your message across. Another thing that comes in deployment is, mera jewelry ka ad hai, should I put it on a jewelry site, context site, or should I put it on other sites which are not jewelry related, right? So here, there's an example of an automotive ad, and don't worry about the bars. The bars are very simple. What they are saying is, I expose X number of people, say 100, to the ad, in wherever I have placed it on digital, and similar consumers where I don't expose them. And if the exposed ones say brand awareness for my brand is 75, Ranade Jewelers, for example, and the other say 70, delta the bar is 5, right? So the brown ones, the golden ones are where the ad was placed in an automotive context site. And the gray ones are where the automotive ad is placed in a non-automotive site. Right, same for entertainment. Now what we see, if it was about awareness, you don't see much of a difference where you place your ad, right? But if you are driving purchase intent, especially on an automotive kind of a site, it is logical. Car kharidne wala, car ka site. You actually see a big delta when you place your ads in sites which are specific to automotive, right? So there is a difference. So now, if your plan, your media plan is more about, or the objective of your media is more about creating awareness, please spread your ad across different types of sites. It might be cheaper, because only jewelry, only automotive sites might be costlier. But if your objective is to drive intention, please pay that extra money, but be on category relevant sites, because you will get more back for it. Right? So there are these subtle nuances, but you know your efficiency is coming in, your message is being driven. Another example on this, instead of numbers being thrown at you, is we tested an Airbnb ad in UK. Okay, Teeds is a global media platform. They helped, they put the ad. Now this ad was placed in news context sites, lifestyle context sites, and also travel sites. What would be expected? Travel sites would give a big, better impact. If you actually see the numbers at the bottom, the increased awareness or delta awareness was more in news and lifestyle sites than on travel sites. This is actual research data. Why? Maybe it got lost in all the travel ads in the travel sites, but it stood out here, right? So first, what is the objective of your campaign? If it is awareness, spread it. If it is purchase intention, consideration, focus on the sites which are relevant to your category. So both deployment and creative coming in. The second part after context is synergy. Now what is synergy? Before coming to what is synergy and how synergy can be looked at when you are using media touch points, one thing we have seen is for most of the campaigns that we have tested, if the delta was X or 100, actually 1/3 of the delta comes from synergistic, the campaign being synergistic across media. So how can one build synergy in a media campaign? One thing to know is, again, this is coming from global data about 1,000 studies. If you look at different media touch points you use, the touch points themselves have synergy between them. The darker green line means those touch points have more synergy, right? The more you go towards golden or red lines, they don't have synergy. So across countries, even in India today, still TV is the glue. But you see coming up saying maybe a TV, outdoor, and a Facebook make a very good kind of synergistic touch point. So if my campaign has certain objectives, how do I use synergistic touch points? What role do I give to each media channel in them is very important. That's about touch points and how you use them. The second is about your creative itself. So again, to explain the numbers to you, suppose I am running a campaign on TV, print, outdoor, digital, etc., but all my ads are very different. They don't connect with each other, and I get a delta in my awareness. Let's make it 100. Even if I had run my TV ad on YouTube, or my print ad and my outdoor or my Facebook display was similar, for the same money, I would have 31% more delta. Right? Now, if I make ads which are integrated, which are same, similar, but also customize them to the context or to the media they are in. Like we said, in a YouTube, people skip after 7 seconds, or in a Facebook, the skip is 3. So if I actually customize my ads, but also they are integrated, for the same money, I am getting 57% more back from the same money in that campaign. Right? So making your creatives, which are multimedia integrated and also customized to that media, helps you get more bang for the buck. One example here, it's not moved, sorry. This campaign, you see the media or the creatives across media being very integrated. It's an old campaign. It did give a significant uplift on various brand metrics, including consideration. But what we saw was, of all the uplifts, 53% came because of synergy. Right? So with same money, you can get more if you build integrated and customized creatives. Now comes the part of, and we have been talking about since morning, experience and engagement. Again, our data shows that the consumer is engaged in their mobile on various different things, and we are trying to put our ad there. We are disturbing their engagement with the mobile. So what should we give them back that they engage with our creative? Right? So there's a value spectrum of you can do a lot. Consumers at different points or different TGs look for either the latest news, or they look for deals, they look for location-based info, they look for fun features, right? But also, we saw in the morning two presentations talking about the use of technology, right? Whether it's digital or whether it is a physical mode, where, you know, you gave consumers to interact with the screen when they walked into a shop. Similarly, you can use mobile, the features of mobile, whether it is audio, whether they can scan something, whatever the features, make apps. So this example, I think you are aware, we also have a partner today on AR, but this was a example which Tanish did last year where they used AR. If you can play this.
Creatively leveraged on the existing technology of the AR filter of Beauty Plus and showcased its two ranges of jewelry, gold and diamond. A special AR filter was created for Tanishq to demonstrate two different jewelry items. With the gesture recognition feature induced, the user could try both the designs. Once the user downloads the filter and tries it, she could pout and the action would switch the jewelry from gold to diamond. People downloaded them and shared them on social media. With this, Tanishq's exquisite diamond and gold collection entered thousands of phone galleries.
You already have an AR partner, but it's again using the mobile. How do you engage better? How do you give them a better experience to get the consumers to you? And the last learning is about creating balance. A lot discussion happens on, I have spent, what did I get? How many clicks did I get, right? That's the way we evaluate effectiveness of a campaign. But what we see is there is no correlation between just the clicks versus the brand impact, right? And a lot, I mean, we asked clients, every advertiser understands there has to be a mix of short term and long term. But when it comes to on ground, everything becomes skewed towards short term. People end up forgetting the long term. So there are ways you can measure, and I'm showing you a case of a jewelry brand from USA where they did an analysis of what drives sales, which channel drives sales. And if you see the various media touch points or channels they looked at, if you look at just the short term, print, influencers, out of home search were coming very closer. But if you add the long term impact of a channel to it, the scenario completely changes. So you need to look at what you are doing is helping you get what you want in the short term, because you need to survive the long term, but also not to forget brand building in the long term. And you can actually do that. Again, based on whether it's a what kind of creative you are putting on, you can get a better mix of media channels to get the objectives of long term and short term together. So that's what the whole talk was about, four learnings. Context matters. You can make the most, understand the context, put the creative accordingly. Synergy and customization to context together are very important to get more for the same amount of money you put in. Engage, experience, give consumers relevant experience to get them, and balance between performance marketing and long-term brand building. Thank you.
Many thanks to you, Sandeep, for this fabulous and insight presentation. We're going to request you kindly hold on here with us. We're going to present a very special token of love and a memento. To do the honors, may we please request Mr. Jignesh Mehta of Divine Solitaires to kindly be with us. Thank you, dear sir.